how do brands use Facebook, and what are some things to think about with your brand teams? And I built a list of 2,900 startups on Facebook. So, you know,
2,900?
2,900 startups. And that lets me watch 3,000 startups all day long on and how what are they feeding their fans.
How did you pick those guys?
I'm good at finding startups. So if I, yeah, if you're here pitching me a new startup, I enter, like, what's your startup?
Scruddle.
So that's this thing here, right?
Yeah.
I'm already following it, see? And then I go add to interest list, and I built lists, so I put it on the right list, right? And here's your feed. So you're doing something that I'm telling you. When you put a link, make it simple. Put the words click here, or click here to get more information, or get a discount if you click here, or some sort of
bit tacky.
It's tacky, but it works. 80% more clicks if you
click. Did you hear that, guys?
And I learned this.
80% more clicks.
Because I did this talk at 500 startups, and one of the people is building a social media monitoring tool, right. And they are monitoring the kinds of things that marketers do to get more engagement, more sales. I mean, it's really about sales at the end of the day. If this stuff doesn't drive sales, why do it, right? If it's just about putting a pretty cat photo up and getting a lot of likes, you're probably not. Why are you doing that as a business? Unless it's part of your story. And that's what I want to executives think through. You know, why are you putting stuff up? Is it part of your story? Does it fit into what you want people to know about your company, you know? In my case, I want people to know Rackspace is a technologically cool company, that we're a leading company, that we're on the bleeding edge. So that's why they pay me, right? It's part of the story.
And but you do that by association.
But I do it by every post.
Most execs.
I don't post a lot of cat photos.
No.
Even though a cute cat photo will get a lot of likes, and my stepmom will share it with her friends. But I don't want my stepmom. I want the CTO and the CEO and the developer to know about Rackspace and care about it.
Yeah.
You know, feel some emotional tie to it.
So you just think this is online storytelling?
It's online storytelling. That's all this is. You know,
for individuals and for brands.
Yeah. So.
But how do you get execs interested who are not interested in all this stuff?
Well, you know, they're paying me, so they're somewhat interested, you know. They see it drives a lot of sales. And first of all, start monitoring sales that come off this. You know, build monitoring systems. You know, okay, let's back up. If you're running a company, like an airline or a plumbing company, whatever company, you're going to have churn. You know, customers are going to leave you for some reason. You screwed up. One of your sales reps, like at Comcast, pissed off somebody. And they're going to, what's their first impulse? Go to Twitter and say, this company sucks.
Right.
Comcast sucks. They just did X to me. And if you have a team that watches that and takes care of those things, you'll save a lot of sales. We've saved millions of dollars of sales.
Just from listening.
By listening, by reducing churn, by, you know, hey, every company, we have a really good company, really great people, great customer service, but every company, even the good ones, piss people off once in a while.
Yeah.
And if you can grab them before they really leave and turn them into a customer again and turn them back into happy, you can save millions of dollars of value there.
But how many people have you got listening all the time?
There's a team of more than 10 people. It's 24 hours a day. Somebody is listening 24 hours a day. All night long.
And if there's any issue, they get that to the relevant guy.
Yeah, and plus, even when you're not listening, I sign in and I can see every tweet that somebody made about Rackspace, right? And we have a listening tool. We built a tool that lets us categorize these sayings and even assign them to people. You know.
So you custom built that?
Somebody on our team. Yeah. We had
so that's not something you bought off the shelf.
No,
that's bespoke.
We custom built it, and actually, that has now been turned into a company that you're going to start hearing about. That you can buy the tool that we developed for our.
So that's become a spinoff.
Yeah.
So that's a startup inside.
It's called Help Social.
So, oh, wow.
Yeah. Check. Help Social. There we go. I'm already following it, too. Yep.
So that's a new code that's come out of your own experience of listening.
Yeah, yeah. So we build a listening tool. So the listening thing has been done.
Yep.
Every company in the world should have a listening team if it's a major company, like an airline or, you know, a bookseller or whatnot. The new thing is these new content management people who are trying to come up with content for Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn and Google Plus to create thought leadership. Why do you want thought leadership? Because it drives sales, right? Because would you rather buy something from somebody who is really smart and interesting and has
of course
something interesting to say to the world? Of course you would. So that's why we do content marketing. And that's what I'm studying is what are the techniques of modern storytelling in the modern world with these tools. Because, hey, there's 1.3 billion people on Facebook. So if you talk to an executive and they're not interested in talking to 1.3 billion people, I would look at them and tell them that. Like, are you, really? You're not interested in talking to 1.3 billion people? That's an interesting statement to make as an executive of a,
that is a,
of
good,
a company.
That is a right? good line. You're not interested in, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Tell us about how you use Facebook. Tell us.
I use it all day long. I have
so you're on it. You're on it 24 hours a day when you're not sleeping.
Yeah. Even when I'm sleeping, I wake up and look at it.
And you tell us how you've refined your stream and what. Tell us what Facebook are up to.
Like here, I see something I don't want to see. It's not interesting to me, so I hide it. That little hide teaches the engines that are running underneath Facebook to show you fewer of those kinds of things.
So you're training the algorithms to feed you better.
Yeah.
And how much time has that taken you to?
Thousands of hours.
Thousands of hours to train the algorithms to produce a better stream. You have to think about that.
I'm using it as a tool for me to see what is happening amongst my customers and amongst the world faster than my competitor. Because if I can see a trend before Werner at Amazon can see it, I can jump on top of it. And we
and
can
maybe
have,
get an opportunity out of it.
Yeah, we might, you know, if Bitcoin is hot, all of a sudden we do announce a Bitcoin thing, right? And we get PR because we're the first. That happens all day long, right?
So you're like a, you're like reconnaissance.
Yeah. Oreos cookies, right? They watch Twitter and Facebook during the Super Bowl, and they have a team working to create media during the Super Bowl or during the World Cup, right? And they see a trend, like the lights go out in a stadium or something happens, somebody scores a goal, and they have, in a minute, they have a picture out, you know, on their Twitter account making, you know, making some fun of it or giving you some information or just trying to attach their brand to the news event so that when it goes in the Twitter stream, everybody's like, oh, the Oreos is cool. You know?
Yeah.
So if you do a search on Google for Oreos Super Bowl, right?
You've got your stream over there on Twitter. There's 40,000 people on that stream.
Yeah.
Handpicked. But you're spending all your time on Facebook.
Yeah. Yeah, Super Bowl. In fact, look, Google already knows that people are searching for this thing. And how Oreo won the Super Bowl, right? You know, with I'm on Wired. The internets, they sometimes are slow.
Look at that loading time. Center of Silicon Valley in Half Moon Bay.
So here's the tool.
How fast is your pipe, by the way, here?
100 megabit down, 60 megabit down, something like that, and 10 up.
16 down, 10 up.
60 up and down and 10 up, yeah.
So here, 60 makes down and 10 makes up.
So here, when the lights went out at the Super Bowl, they had this out in a couple minutes that said you can still dunk in the dark, you know? And it became
The power failed.
It became a funny ad that was part of the conversation when the power failed, right? And
so they made it a positive.
And look at how many retweets. 16,000 retweets, right?
Yeah, very clever.
Okay, cover for
a cookie brand.
For cover business.
You still have clout embedded in your Twitter.
Yeah,
what's your view on clout?
It's not that important, but it does let you see roughly how influential somebody is. Roughly. You know, if
so
you have
it's not that important,
80,
but it's roughly accurate.
It's roughly accurate, and I watch it. So if somebody says something about Rackspace and they have a a cloud of 10, I'll treat it a little differently than if the person had a cloud of 80.
Sure.
Right? If they have a cloud of 80, I will email every executive and say, we have a PR problem. Because
so then it's really important, Cloud.
Yeah. It's important at a
when they're at the top.
When you're at the bottom of the top, when there's a difference like that. It's not important. It's not important to worry about, do I have 88 or 87? You know, if you're in the 80s, you're very influential. If you're in the 10s, you're not influential at all, you know? So, yeah. And you can see that.
Facebook for business more.
Yeah.
So that's
Facebook for business. So
for executives.
Yeah. How does an executive use Facebook for business? At a big cup.
First, I would stop thinking that it's for family photos and all that fun stuff. Yeah. Keep using it for your family photos. You put all your family on the family list, so you can click over here and see all your family, right?
Right.
And see all their stupid cat photos and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Right. And et cetera, et cetera. And you could tell there's no signal there for my family. I wish all they would do is post baby photos. Then it would actually be interesting. But if you, here I have a list of 500 tech journalists.
500 tech journalists.
And brands. So Hacker News. And so I can just in 2 minutes scroll through this and see what the news is in my industry. Now, you should build a list of your own industry, you know?
Yeah. Well, should build a list in their own niche.
If you're a salesperson at Boeing, I would build a list like this of American Airlines and United Airlines and airline bloggers and people in the airline industry, so I can start watching who are these people and what are they saying. And then I would have a list of execs I know. You know, if I'm a salesperson, I already have a list of people I touch. And then I would follow them on and friend them on Facebook so that I know something about who they are, which turns into sales, right? If I know you don't like golf and I try to take you golfing, that won't make any points with you, will it?
Right?
But if I know you're really passionate about golfing, I'm going to get over my hatred of golf and take you golfing because...
hate golf as well. I hate golf too.
I know, but if you love golf and all you did was talk about golf and I wanted to close you as a sale, the first thing I would do is learn how to play golf and take you out on the golf course because I get 4 hours of you, right?
Yeah,
the Stanford Business School, they make the kids learn to play golf because they know a lot of business happens on golf courses. It's smart.
I see it.
I live on a golf course, so I see the kind
it
of
does.
Networking.
It's true. It's true.
You know, if you hang out at the Ritz at the end of the golf course, you get a lot of good people.
Now, talking about the Ritz, have the Ritz finally figured out who you are now? It's 2014. Yeah. They do know who you are.
Yeah.
So when you walk
the director of marketing or the vice president of marketing came up and said hi, you know, when he was doing an offsite. So they know who I am.
So do they know how to take care of you when you walk in?
Now they do. Yeah, I have them.
But it took them 4 years to notice you.
Well,
because when we were here in 2010.
Keep in mind, I don't spend money in the hotel, so they
you still buy drinks and fries and.
Right, and it took a while for them because their systems aren't connected. It turns out, and it took a while for them to realize somebody spent $10,000 at our bar, and is bringing all these cool people because they're. They weren't. Their systems were not advanced either, but they're getting more and more advanced over time. And so when you walk into a Ritz, and if you are at the hotel, and you have 100 room nights at the hotel, they treat you different than they treat me.
Right? Of course,
you know
you would expect that.
Learned if you're a company and you bring 20 people for an offsite, you're treated differently than if I just walk in because. If you piss off the executive at like Salesforce has its offsites here, right? If you piss off Mark Benioff, what does that mean to your business? It's $1 million mistake, you know? And generally people don't make $1 million mistakes.
but would Ritz know with Mark, with someone like Mark, would Ritz know when he walks in? Are they reading his
face
pretty quickly?
At the airport?
No, the minute he gets to the counter, they know he's there. They know he's coming. Yeah.
Okay, so
if he's staying in the hotel. Now, if he's just walks on the property without having a hotel reservation, without having a dinner reservation, no, they don't know that. Then they have to have smart people who
know, yes. Yeah.
But can you see a time when they have facial recognition and they look up the clout and they say that's Mark Benioff?
They don't even need to do that, because inside everybody's phone is a beacon, and this beacon sprays three numbers into the air every second if it turns.
This is the iBeacon.
And so the minute that Mark Benioff's phone walks onto the property, it's going to know he's there. And people will be like, okay, we have a king. We have a whale. In Vegas, they call those whales, right?
Yeah, we have a whale.
We have a new whale, and we didn't even know the whale was showing up, but we're going to treat him like a whale. And Mr. Benioff, what do you need? You need a room?
But the Ritz-Carlton, have they put iBeacons in so that they can receive the messages?
But they're working.
We talked
with their executive.
So all the retailers, all the hotels are going to put in these items. Yeah,
so wrap it up, guys. What's the final thing you're going to? What's the?
I don't know. We could go on for hours because Facebook is thousands of little things, and it's if you do enough of them right, all of a sudden your feed gets better, your conversation gets better, your friends get better, your reputation in the world gets better, right? And people pass your information along to their friends. And so,
Facebook's feeding your clout.
Yeah. Cloud is pretty good about tracking gross influence, you know.
So, if you were thinking about the most important platform between Facebook and LinkedIn and Twitter and Google Plus,
for me, Facebook is the most important, but they're all important because they all have different audiences.
Yeah.
Okay. So, what's Facebook important
for? If you're a teenage music star, Instagram or Snapchat is most important because that's. When I went to Coachella, that's what people were using on their phones.
Okay.
Facebook is still important, but maybe number three. If you're talking to business people, Facebook and LinkedIn. LinkedIn, if you need a job or if you need to talk about business development, that's what we do on LinkedIn, right? It's a great network of business people. And
what about Twitter and Google Plus?
Twitter is important for following what news and public conversation is about your business and about your industry. Google Plus is important for SEO, and there's some audiences there that are large and passionate. And there's people you can reach there that you can't reach on Facebook because there's an anti-Facebook thing going on over at Google Plus. It depends who you are and what your story is. And that's why I ask, what is your story? You know, what is your story and what do you want to change about your story?
What is your story and what do you want to change about your story? Right. It's August 2014 and we are in Half Moon Bay.
Yeah, that's good.
With the Scoble.
Thanks.
Cheers.
See you.